He's now in a cul-de-sac. It's going to be a dead end, and we'll see what he's done. He's already been willing to off-road this pursuit, and there he goes through a fence.
Right through the fence,
and now looking for another street or access road. This time, he's going to end up in a parking lot. I don't know if LAPD is going to be able to make it through that fence with him.
I think that's a big decline right there, too. I don't think he could take it.
He's coming down the hill. He's coming down the hill. It is an incline. He's coming down, and the Ford Taurus is holding up pretty well here. He's going to encounter another fence. And as I mentioned, he already made his way into the LA River further east of here. Now it looks like he's stuck.
He's stuck now.
That's it. That might be the end of this pursuit. We will see
if he decides to give up here.
Now at 11, shocking video capturing a brazen smash-and-grab robbery in the middle of San Francisco traffic. Watch as a man gets out of that Honda Accord, punches his hand through the rear glass of the Prius, pulls out what appears to be a backpack before leaping back into the car and speeding off. The victims are a husband and wife real estate photography team. They say the men stole $7,000 worth of camera equipment.
The video is everywhere. An enterprising neighbor was up at 8 Wednesday morning and caught it all on camera. The woman busts out a window in the Jeep, pours gasoline inside, and then throws a match. The force of the explosion she's caused throws her backward, but she crawls back to pick up the gas can and takes off as the Jeep begins to go up in flames.
Yeah, that's Chicago Mayor Lori Lightfoot coming out in full costume, cape and mask as the Rona, as in Corona Destroyer, handing out candy to reporters and staff at her daily news conference. Trick-or-treaters will be asked to stay in groups of six or fewer there, avoid sticking their hands into any candy bowls, and of course, wear a mask with a mask over your mask. That's it.
This Florida man, in case that little forehead tattoo didn't give it away, was arrested for misuse of 911 and possession of marijuana. WFLA reports 22-year-old Matthew Leatham lives in Newport Richey, and around 4 in the morning, he didn't have a ride home. So he called 911, cursed at a dispatcher who gave him the non-emergency number for future reference. A responding deputy offered to call him a taxi, but he didn't have the money, so he started walking. Moments later, he called 911 a second time asking for a ride and was arrested. They also found marijuana on him. Leatham was released after posting $300 bail.
Suspect, a 32-year-old man, climbed about 60 feet up in that tree and spent nearly 3 hours hiding out there before slowly coming down and being taken into police custody. Here's a video from earlier where you can see Bothell police. And as we move in closer to the tree, that's where the suspect stayed, refusing to come down at first. That led to a big crime scene with police attempting to talk with the suspect here in the 18,000 block of Bothell Everett Highway. Now, police say this all started before 10:30 this morning. Police received a report of a motorcycle that was traveling about 114 miles per hour. The motorcycle crashed into a barrier and another vehicle on I-405 in Bothell. Police say the motorcyclist ran and stole a white car from a parking lot. And we are told by investigators that during this ordeal, someone who saw what was happening fired shots that hit the tire of the white car. No one was hurt. The suspect was able to drive north, and there was a brief pursuit before it was called off because the suspect was allegedly driving erratically. From there, the suspect ended up in that tree. Firefighters put up a ladder, and he slowly made his way down around 2:30 this afternoon.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to. This is my mom's car, and I was moving.
Okay, well, you need to call your mom up here and give me your insurance card. I'm calling the police. Thank you so much. Get your car. What? You get in the car. You get in the car. You get in my car. What the are you doing?
Okay, now to quite the wild story here. A man who's being called the turkey burglar now behind bars after sneaking into a home in Washington County early this morning.
It's super creepy.
Dana Huntington came outside early Thanksgiving morning to find a stranger rummaging through his car.
And he had several coats on and he had a backpack on.
Deputies say that man was Antonio Bernal of Battleground, Washington. Dana ran out to confront him while his wife called 911.
I made him empty his pockets on the ground, and all the stuff in the backpack and in his pockets were tools and things from inside my garage.
Dana soon realized this unwanted holiday visit included more than a car prowl.
When he was emptying his pockets, he handed me keys of mine that I knew were inside a cupboard inside my house. So that was even more unnerving. You've been inside my house when all my kids and my wife and I were asleep upstairs.
In fact, Dana said Bernal went through cupboards and made himself at home, eating rolls and other portions of their Thanksgiving meals, drinking cider, and taking soda from the fridge.
He went into our pantry cupboard and pulled out some mini marshmallows, and mini marshmallows were everywhere inside my van, inside our house. He ate a whole 2 foot long Hillshire Farm sausage in one sitting. There's just left the wrapper. He'd been grabbing food. He had a whole gallon jug of cider that he drank half of. He definitely spent some time in my living room eating the rolls and things.
Dana says he used the downstairs bathroom in the house and didn't flush, and also used a cooler in the family's van as a toilet. Deputies arrived quickly and arrested the uninvited house guest.